Welcome to RyGurukul.com. In this video, we'll discuss about ad hoc testing. Ad hoc testing is an informal or unstructured software testing type that aims to break the testing process in order to find possible defects or errors at an early possible stages. Ad hoc testing is done randomly. So whenever we will get and build person or the team of ad hoc testing team will start the testing on random basis to find the defect. So we'll see here in detail what is ad hoc testing, types of ad hoc testing, when do we need that ad hoc testing, best practices, and finally the advantage and disadvantages of ad hoc testing. So if you don't know about this, please watch this video from start to end of the content. And if you're visiting this channel for the first time, don't forget to like and subscribe the channel for further update. So as I said, ad hoc testing does not allow any structured way of testing. It is randomly done on any part of the applications. So let's say if we are working on e-commerce site and we want to test that complete e-commerce website, then definitely we have to perform the ad hoc testing on major feature first. So let's say we have the purchase order, order details, then profile activity, all the content, list of the products. So these all we have to verify thoroughly so that we can make sure or so that we can confirm that this product is working perfectly fine. So ad hoc testing is an informal or unstructured. That's the reason it is called as informal and unstructured. There is no structure defined within it, and this aims to test the complete applications to find the early defects. Ad hoc testing is done randomly and it is usually an unplanned activity which does not follow any documentations and test design techniques to create the test cases. So without using any test cases, teams are performing ad hoc testing, which is achieved with the software testing techniques called error guessing. It means error guessing can be done by people having enough experience on the system to guess the most likely source of error which we will get. Generally, this type of testing is performed by tester and developer. The combination of tester and developer, those who are building the product, they are having good idea where they might miss. And with that, one of the tester or the team of the tester will be involved, and this type of testing, ad hoc testing, will have several contents to test it. Generally, the result of this type of testing we have to produce in early phases. That's the reason this will be performed by internal team members. Now, what all types of ad hoc testing we have? So there are two types of ad hoc testings. First is buddy testing and second is peer testing. So let's understand what is buddy testing. Generally, in buddy testing, there are two persons or the teams of developer and tester will be involved for doing the complete product testing, where they are generally focusing or they are generally targeting the main functionality of the applications. So let's consider another example of WhatsApp applications. In WhatsApp applications, we have five major components. One is Messenger, which we are sending and receiving the contents from there. Then second is audio calling. Third is video calling. Fourth is settings. And fifth is payment gateway. So these are the five major components we have in WhatsApp applications. So generally, whenever ad hoc testing will start, the person who is involved into the ad hoc testing, they will verify all five major functionality rather than going into the deep. So major functionality, they will check it like doing call one-on-one or adding multiple person into the same call, then checking the video quality on one-on-one video quality as well as in conference calling. So these all will be covered in buddy testings. When the unit testing is performed on the application, then only we can perform buddy testing. This type of testing helps developer team and testing team to do their jobs. Second is pair testing. This type of testings are involvement of testers will be included to test this complete software on the website, which this year's idea and finding the defects on the applications. One of them will test the application, other one can review and analyze the applications. So this is how pair testing can be performed. That generally depending on the team size of a tester, how many members will be involved. But here each functionality will have two persons. One is generally doing the complete testing and second is reviewing their applications. So this is called as pair testing. Now, when do we perform ad hoc testing? When they are having a multiple releases on the product in the market, we go for the ad hoc testing because the customer never uses the application in sequence or semantically. For that sake, we have to verify it end-to-end that application major functionalities that does not affect anything. And ad hoc testing by checking the application randomly without following any sequence or procedure, since user does not know how to use the application, they may use it randomly and find some issues. To cover this, onto one round of ad hoc testing is normally preferred. So generally here again, whenever the product will move into the productions or whenever that product is ready for the production, that time ad hoc testing will be performed. Even when we have a big product cycle or big product cycle, in that case also in the frequent release cycles, we are doing the ad hoc testings. Before that, we cannot proceed into the final phase of the testing. Now, which all best practices we have? First is good business knowledge. Generally, the person who is performing this type of activity, that person should have the complete knowledge about the product. Unless and until they don't know about the complete functionality, they won't be able to verify it. So again, let's consider the same example of WhatsApp application. In WhatsApp applications, we have five functionality. If the person who don't know how to make the payment or how to make a video call with multiple person, they will just verify it one-to-one call rather than adding multiple person into the same call. So the person who is doing this type of texting, they should have the senior person as well as the complete knowledge about the product or the requirement documents. Based on that person will verify to test that applications. So business knowledge will be most required. Either that person is from the senior management team or that person is from the senior testing team or senior QA lead or test lead. So these type of person is performing this testing. Then test key modules. Which all modules we have? First, we have the knowledge and what all will be delivered into that particular release. These details will be required. And if we have these details, that will be more better and efficient way of the testing. Then generally in many of the organizations is observed, they are not logging the defect. Either they are just informing to the development team and quickly that development team is fixing this type of defect whenever they will find it out. But it's always suggested to log or record these defects either in the Excel file or if we have Jira or Rally type of tool or any project management tool which we are using. So by the way, if you don't know about Jira and Rally, I've already created a playlist for Jira and Rally. I will include in my description tab. From there, you can use this. Over there, I have created more than 50 videos for each of the topics with explained stepwise. So generally recording the defect will comes under best practices so that we can always track in future as well as whenever it is required, we can go and check it out which defects is released or which defect is found in which release. So these are the best practices. There are several other contents like better to have the person who is having senior level experience who will verify this defect. Now, again, Best practices will include good business knowledge that should have good business clear understanding of the requirement which we have discussed. So this is the detail about the practices of ad hoc testing. Now, what all advantages and disadvantages we have in ad hoc testing? So generally, this testing can be done quickly. It can be performed anytime in the software development lifecycle. The test engineer can test the application in their new ways that help us to find out many number of bugs as compared to the actual testing process. The developer can also execute ad hoc testing while developing the module that helps them to code in better way. When the in-depth testing is required in less time, ad hoc testing can be performed and also deliver the quality product on time. So these are the advantages of ad hoc testing. But when we talk about the disadvantages, they're always having two coins or two faces of the coins. So generally, covering advantages is not a best practice, whether we have to understand the disadvantages of any testing. So generally, this type of testings might give us multiple defects in many phases. It's possible to release or to miss some of the defects while doing this type of testing. These defects might be from the medium level or major level. The chances will be more because this testing is not having any structure. The person who is verifying this type or doing this type of testing that might not aware of the complete requirement. That's the reason they might miss the defects. Second is generally this type of testing might go to and through because we don't have any structure related to this. Third is the major disadvantage, we are not reporting or we are not calculating in any way while doing ad hoc testing. So loss of time as well is a main point. So these are few of the disadvantages of doing ad hoc testing. So that's all from this video. If you think so, we can also come up with several other contents. Please add in our channel comment so that we can add few more contents for you related to software testing. And if you think so, we might have several other points into ad hoc testing. Please include it so that will be useful for our viewer. Thank you for watching.